I originally started this video to show a client of mine how to synchronize files between a server and a computer. Typically you would use this if you want to back up files, automate the process by synchronizing, or especially if you have a laptop and you want to synchronize with your server, and then you can take the files with you wherever you go. This is a program you can find for free on download.com, and just type in Syncback Freeware and you'll be able to download it. When it's downloaded, you can open that up and you'll get a window here saying you don't have any profiles, would you like to create one now? So yes, we do. And then you're going to be asked what type here. Is it going to be a backup or a synchronization? We're going to choose synchronization. Okay that. Then we have to give it a name. So I'm just going to call it test sync. And okay that. So now we get the program up here. We need to choose a source and a destination. So for the source, I'm going to choose my Z drive. Then the destination is going to be a folder on my desktop. So I'll just click this folder and go to under the desktop. I can see it right here. Just okay that. So now I've got my source and destination in place. And by default, now you can choose any one of these options here. And by default, you've got to synchronize the source directories, files, and subdirectories with the destination directory. That'll do everything. The other one would be if you want to exclude certain subdirectories, or you want to just do the files and not the subdirectories. And then of course you have just the backup options. There's a whole lot of other options in here, but if we just do the defaults, selecting the source, destination, leave this on by default, and then we're going to go down to the bottom here and click OK. Then it's because I chose a Z drive, it's a mapped drive to a single folder that has all the files on the other computer. Because it is seeing it as a drive letter, it thinks that it's the entire hard drive, so it's giving you a warning that it's not a good idea to do that. You don't want to back synchronize the entire hard drive, so of course not. I know that it's fine to do what I have set up, so I'm going to say yes. And then it wants to know if we can do a simulated run on the profile. We can say yes to that and just let it go. So it's doing a test synchronize, searching for changes, and I don't recommend doing the test because it takes so long and it looks like it's not going to go anywhere. The actual sync takes no time at all. So I'm going to stop this. There's a problem with the test sync. Even trying to stop, it takes a long time. So I wouldn't recommend doing this test sync on here because of this. So you see what happens now, it sits here for so long and who knows how long it's going to take. So we'll have to do the famous Control-Delete, and you cannot delete the profile because it's currently, is it still, it still says it's running. So I'm going to end the task for it. Are you sure? Yeah. And now I have to just kill the program. Can't expect much for free. Okay, now it's closed. Get out of here and relaunch the program. There, now we're able to delete that file. So we have no profiles here. So we're going to go down to create a new profile. And then again, it's synchronized and okay. Test sync. So we're going to go through all this again. So I can choose my drive letter. So from there to there, keep that the same. Okay, are you sure? Yeah. Would you like to do the simulated run? No, because it froze last time. It's done this to me a couple times before I started doing this video. So I know it consistently seems to freeze on a test, but hit run, tells us the differences that it sees in the files here. That's fine, we can go to continue run. And we have success. It works, it's done, that's the end of it. Now, I have these two files here, of course I didn't show you. If I get rid of this from here and this from here, so we have a text file on my local one and a bitmap image on the Z drive. I'm going to highlight this and say run and continue run. We have success and we have results. So the text file is showing here with some content. It's both the same. Now whichever one I edit this on, put in a bunch of stuff and save that, and then I'm gonna hit highlight and run and continue run because it told me there were some differences, and now it shows up over here. So it works both ways, and that's it. Now if you want, you can go to schedule, and it tells us that there is no schedule for the profile. Yeah, we want to create one, and yes, we'll have to enter in our password for that. So now we get this here to set a password. And then we'll go up to create a schedule. Daily, 9 a.m., whatever time you want to choose. And then just OK that. You now have a schedule. And you can OK that. And it's set. Then you just minimize it and it will run at every day at that time. And that's it. Nothing else to do. Both source and destination will be synchronized with all the files, folders, subfolders every day at the time that you specified on the schedule, or whenever you open up this program and highlight the profile and hit run. That's it. Hopefully you find this video helpful. There's a lot more options you can do in here, going into modify the profile and going through the various tabs. Even down at the bottom here, there's an expert button that when you hit that, now you've got all kinds of other tabs up here giving you tons of other options, and it's going to take a lot to go through them all, but if you're interested, I can make more videos that show through the details on how these things work. Anyway, that's it for now. Hopefully you found this video informative, and post your comments. Subscribe to the channel. If you don't subscribe, you won't know about the new videos that come out. And it's a good way to keep track of things, and as well, you'd need that to make your comments on there as well. Thank you very much, and see you again soon.